dear students, I am Dr. Kumar, Assistant Professor of Zoology, Government First Grade College, Shira. The topic of the today's lecture is the mouth parts of cockroach, that is the trophy of insects, that belongs to the paper 4, that is insect vectors and diseases. You can see this slide shows the mouth parts of cockroach. Mouth parts of cockroach is of biting and chewing type. Where you can see this is the upper lip, what is called as labrum. On either side of the upper lip you can see the mandibles. Okay, they are the grinders and they are responsible for cutting the food into small pieces. Okay. And the next is a pair of maxilla, okay, and the lower lip, what is called as the labium. In the middle you can see a short tongue like structure, what is called as hypopharynx. All these structures constitute the mouth parts of the cockroach. Let us go the structures or the parts one by one. Mouth parts of cockroach. The mouth parts of cockroach is of biting and chewing type. Biting and chewing type. This type of mouth parts, that is the chewing type of mouth parts, are considered as very primitive and unspecialized type of mouth parts in organisms. The other examples that includes the grasshoppers, dragonfly, and also in beetles can also be seen this type of the mouth parts. Also we can see the same chewing and the biting type of mouth parts can also be seen in the larvae of mosquito, housefly, butterfly and honeybee. They are also having this type of mouth parts. So let us go by part by part. The first part, it is what is called as the labrum. It is also known as the upper lip. The labrum is also known as the upper lip. So the mouth is covered by the labrum. It is also known as the upper lip. This labrum is attached to the clypeus. Clypeus is nothing but, so it is a sclerite. It is usually present at the front part of the head. It is a sclerite. Okay. So the labrum helps in tasting and also handling the food. The labrum helps in tasting the food and also the handling the food material. The next is mandibles. The mandibles. So here you can see these two somewhat triangular structures having a teeth-like structures or the denticles, what is called as the teeth-like sharp structures. They are called as denticles, and these denticles are helpful in grinding the food materials. Okay, so the mandibles, these are usually paired structures, so usually somewhat triangular in shape. They are hard, unjointed, stouter means they are larger in size, chitinized structure. Chitinized means they are hard and they are meant for grinding the food material, and accordingly they are having a teeth-like processes, sharp teeth-like processes. So by the use of these sharp teeth-like processes, the mandibles are helpful in grinding the food materials. The mandibles are located on either side of the mouth behind the labrum. Behind the labrum, that is the behind the upper lip, on either sides they are located. So they are present along the inner margins, along the inner margin of the oral cavity, and they are masticatory in function. Masticatory, that is grinding the food material. So these mandibles are provided with two pairs of muscles. Two pairs of muscles, that is adductor muscles and abductor muscles. There are two types of muscle fibers are involved in contraction and relaxation. So muscles has to contract and relax in order to move. The movement of the mandibles are achieved due to the presence of this muscle fiber, specialized muscle fibers. that is adductor muscle fibers and abductor muscle fibers. They are helpful in the movement of mandible, so that it will be helpful for the animal to crush or to masticate the food inside the oral cavity. So the movement of these mandibles, they are in a horizontal plane, they are not in the vertical plane. So they move in a horizontal plane during mastication of the food in the oral cavity. So this is about the mandibles. Some are triangular in structures, so they are hard chitinized structure present next to the labrum, situated on either side of the oral cavity, and they are responsible for grinding the food. The next is maxilla. Maxilla, we have seen. So these are the maxilla in the tentacle like structures. These two are the maxillas. Okay. Maxillas are usually paired structures present one on either side. So a pair of the maxilla, they are located behind the mandibles, next to the mandibles on either side. So they are usually present in the mouth. The first maxilla has two basal segments called as caudo and stipes. So the each maxilla is made up of two basal segments, what is called as caudo and stipes. You can see here, each maxilla is made up of two segments, okay, what is called as caudo, and it is the another segment is called as stipes. So both these two are the basal segments, that is the caudo and the stipes. Right, caudo is attached to the head capsule. Caudo is attached to the head capsule, whereas the stipes is attached to the caudo. Okay, so you can see the maxilla is made up of two basal segments called as the caudo and stipes. Caudo is attached to the head capsule and stipes is attached to the caudo segment. Okay, right. Now the stipes have, the stipes has five segmented maxillary pal on its outside. Stipes, you can see, this is the stipes. On outer side of the side, outer edge of the stipe is made up of the five segmented labial pal. This is what is called as the maxillary pal. Here you can see the five segmented maxillary pal. So the maxillary pal, five segmented maxillary pal on its outer side. This pulp is situated on a small sclerite called as palpifer. This is very important. Here you can see the palpifer, this next to the stipes on the outer border, you can see the palpifer, the structure what is called as the palpifer. Next to the palp, you can see the tentacle like structure, five segmented, the maxillary palp. Right. The inner to the palp, two chitinous lobes, namely lacina and galeas, they are found attached to the stipes. Here also you can see, so next to the stipe, the outer border is having the palpifer, followed by the maxillary palp, and the inner side, inner to the palpifer, you can see two important structures, the inner lacina and the outer galea. Okay, so there are two lobes, the what is called as lacina and galea, are found attached to the stripes. Lacina is pincer like with the two terminal denticles, whereas galea is the outer structure bearing a long chitinous bristles, can be seen here. So this lacina is pincer like structure. Pincer means the forceps like structure, having two blunt ends, and it will be helpful in holding the things firmly. Okay, so the pincer like structure, the lacina is a pincer like structure, and having denticles, two denticles, and they are helpful in holding the things firmly. And the outer border of the lacina is followed by the galea having a thin long bristles. The bristles, sensory, the bristles are present in the galea. Right. The maxillary palps are used in the cleaning of the antenna and also the cleaning of the front pair of legs. That is the maxillary palp. Whatever the maxillary palps are present, so these are the tentacle-like structure. So these maxillary palps are helpful in cleaning the antenna and also in cleaning the antenna and also the first pair of legs. The first pair of the front legs. The next part is the labium. Okay, the labium is also known as lower lip. Lower lip. The basal segment of the labium is what is called as postmentum. Okay, the lower lip is made up of many number of segments. The first and foremost is the postmentum. The postmentum. So next to the postmentum, there is submentum. Next to the submentum, there is a mentum. Next to the mentum, there is another segment, what is called as prementum. The prementum. Okay, right. Let us see one by one. The lower lip is made up of a first and foremost segment is called as the postmentum. Next to the postmentum is the submentum. Okay, right. Labium includes two segments, namely rectangular submentum and a triangular the mentum. So the prementum is followed by the prementum is also present. Prementum is formed by the fusion of two stripes. It bears a small sclerite called as palpiger. Here you can see the prementum. Here is the prementum. Prementum encloses two important structures, what is called as glossa and paraglossa. Okay, and at the same time the prementum gives a place for the important structure what is called as palpiger. On either side you can see the palpiger is present. Okay, right. So each palpiger has a three segmented labial palp. Each palpiger has a three segmented labial palp. Here you can see on either side, so one palpiger is present. So each palpiger is having a three segmented labial palp, okay, on outer border, and inside you can see there are two important structure what is called as glossa and inner glossa and outer paraglossa. The next is, that is about the labium. The next is hypopharynx. It is a chitinous grooved and a rod like structure found hanging in the preoral cavity. It is also known as, it is commonly called as tank. Hypopharynx divides into two parts. That is, the larger anterior part is called as sebarium and the posterior part is called as salivarium. Okay, the salivary duct opens into the posterior region of the hypopharynx, that is salivarium, at the base of the hypopharynx. So that is about the hypopharynx. Next, coming to the process of feeding, how the cockroach feeds. Okay, during feeding what happens? Okay, cockroach usually salivate the food outside the mouth cavity before cutting it with the mandibles. So when the cockroach, when it come across the food substances, okay, first and foremost it salivates outside the mouth cavity before the food is cutting with the help of the mandibles. Next is, after the salivation, it takes the food inside the oral cavity and the mandible starts cutting the food. Okay, next is the maxilla. The maxilla or the maxillary palp present on either side of the mouth cavity. So they transport the food into the sebarium, anterior part of the hypopharynx, where the hypopharynx is involved in transporting it between the grinding mandibles. The hypopharynx helpful in providing the food for mastication on either side of the this denticles, which are the part of the mandibles. The crushed food, after the crushing is completed by the mandibles, the crushed food is sucked into the pharynx through a process what is called as dilation. So cockroach feeds on almost anything, the food which is left over by the human beings, human food. So that involves the wood, leather, toothpaste, milk, sugary materials, soap, fabrics, etc. Okay, this is about the process of feeding and the mouth parts of cockroach. Thank you.